You want something done right, you gotta do it yourself.
But how did you manage to extend its longevity? I'm surprised.
Virgil and I were just having the most invigorating discussion.
I was telling Director Rentier about my ideas for upgrading the gauntlet.
I must say, it's refreshing to see young blood like Mr. Olney's coursing through Calico. We'll need his vital spirit if we're to rebuild the Institute's power and vigor. Well done, son.
I think we may have given him a few too many vaults.
Glad to see you're in good shape, but we've got a situation. In order to keep your condition quiet, Amelia told Harrow you died. He's pulled rank and is sending us out on money-grubbing errands while Felicity's building her army.
Harrow's head knows what's right, but his heart is tainted by lust for power and money.
It's gonna get worse now that he got promoted. One wrong move and we're dead in the water.
But one right move, and you could catch her and end this war. On the subject of moving.
You know what? Maybe let's wait for the doc to give the all clear before we start unbinding anyone.
Oh, Edgar. Harrow's not an idiot. Without the Institute, this country would turn into a blood feast. Now, you tell me, son. What's more important? His approval or ending this war before it started?
What did you see while Felicity was in your head?
Death. Horrible monsters appearing out of nowhere. Fire, smoke, everything. And boxcars. Scores of them. Filled with blood.
That's how she's transporting the leeches now? By train?
That's not good, sirs. Dickinson is a major cattle railway hub. The trains run in all directions. If there's an outbreak, we won't be able to contain it.
Jesus Christ, what happened here?
Jesse, I'm too late.
Between you and me, you little leech. Let them go.
Humans build empires in the name of progress, with no thought spared for those paying the mortal cost of their quest for glory. That is true vampirism. My kind would never leave one of their children to die, crying in the gutter.
I won't let you turn them.
You don't listen! They don't matter, Jesse Rentier. The sooner you understand that, the better.
Ah! What now? You're too scared to face me in your own flesh?
Scared I might be able to stop her.
Thank you.
somehow.
Got you now.
train's about to leave the station. Do you hear them singing? That's humanity's requiem. You can be mankind's last sad note, or you can be part of a new opening chord of progress. It's only natural to feel fear while standing on the precipice of change. Sometimes what you need is a little push. Try not to kill him, my child. Let it break poor William's heart.
Thank you. Adapt or die!
There you are. I was starting to worry you'd never wake up.
Feels like I got hit by a train.
Those demons and Dickinson did a real number on you. Still, you'll live to fight another day.
For all the good it did me.
We all have our crosses to bear, my son. Even our Lord Jesus Christ fell 3 times on the fateful road to Calvary. We are none of us immune to trials of the flesh.
At least he could finish his mission.
Oh, come now. Here I thought you Rentiers were made of sterner stuff.
You heard of us? How?
A few of your agents set up camp in the mountains a while back. Quiet lads. But goodness, were they fond of their moonshine.
Didn't know we had a cell up here.
The lightning storms at their camp did much to stoke local superstition about thunderbirds and other such nonsense.
Hold on. Did you say lightning storms?
When they were deep in their cups, they'd ramble on and on about how they could channel the power of lightning through their metal gloves.
I need to contact my people in Calico. Is there a telegraph station nearby?
A couple of miles south, sure. But there's one small problem.
Probably should have led with that, Padre.
They started creeping out from the holes in the ground after we got back from Dickinson. Lord knows how many of them there are by now.
Send your fastest man out to the telegraph station, then get everyone into the church and stay put until dawn.
Before you go, Hunter, one of your people left this explosive contraption here last time. We were afraid to even touch it, but I'm sure you'll put it to good use. Is there anything more we can do to help?
Pray.
No surprise, there's one in the cemetery.
Thank you.
son. It would appear that you're their hero.
Your runner got an answer to my telegram?
Looks like I was right. That mysterious cell in the mountains might have just what I need to upgrade my gauntlet.
The Lord works in mysterious ways.
Yeah, I was afraid you were gonna say something like that.
An occupational hazard, I'm afraid. I'll have Martha set you up with a fresh kit bag before you go.
That won't be necessary.
Son, part of being a hero is knowing when to let people help you. Even Jesus had his disciples.
Yeah, but one of them turned out to be kind of an asshole.
Speaking of which, when those monsters started showing up, we telegraphed the authorities, and they told us not to worry, because Secretary Harrow was on the case personally.
You did us a real kindness last night. I hope you know we won't forget it.
Listen, next time, cut out the middleman and contact us directly. We're in Calico.
I hope you find what you're looking for, son. And let's pray that there'll still be people like us alive once you find it. Because these days, we really need some heroes. Godspeed, Mr. Rentier.